So now that we're getting to the actual show itself, another responsibility that falls to the production coordinator is any stage needs that the band may have, which includes stage towels, stage water, or any special drinks that they like to have on stage. I had an artist once who wanted a whole tea setup right on stage left, and I had to actively make different types of teas throughout the entire performance for his throat. So crazy little things like that are also the production coordinator's responsibility. If you're on a tour that's not traveling with a wardrobe person or a personal assistant, the production coordinator may also be responsible for wardrobe and stage clothes. You might have to steam some things, make sure certain items are cleaned, or help the artist get dressed and ready for the show itself. Depending on the tour, this responsibility could be shared with the production manager, the stage manager, or the tour manager, but just making sure the band is ready and prepping them 30 minutes out, 15 minutes out, 5 minutes out, and the walk to stage itself. Not all shows start on time based on how many audience members are in the theater, so keeping the band updated on when the show's gonna start, keeping them updated on when the show needs to end, if it needs to end at a certain time, and when they need to get off stage, when we need to get out of the venue. Artists typically don't want too much information, just the absolute necessary information that they need to do the show and to get out. So keeping everything very simple for them, but very straightforward is important. I like to print out a little sheet for their dressing room that just says showtime, curfew, leaving. Now that the show is happening, there are a couple different things that you might have to do as a production coordinator. I've been on some tours where I've had to call cues and manage dancers and choirs during the show itself, keeping everybody on track for when they need to be on the stage. But if you're fortunate, this might be your only downtime of the day as a production coordinator. What do you do with this time, you might ask? I'm not used to having an hour of doing nothing. Good question. This is a great time to go back into the dressing rooms and clean up as much as possible. I like to throw out any extra food that's in the room, pack up as much as I can, because after the show is going to be very crazy. So this is a very good time to start packing down the production office, the band dressing rooms, and the crew dressing rooms, making your cleanup process as streamlined as you can. Another great thing to do during the show is sitting down with your production manager, because likely this is the only downtime he or she has had during the day as well, and going through your day sheet for the next day. A day sheet is a sheet that we send out every single day that outlines the schedule for the next day. This sheet has everything from hotel information to the actual schedule itself, venue information, show times, and important times throughout the day. We also send these sheets for travel days. If we're taking a flight or taking a ferry or taking a bus, you will receive a day sheet every single night from your production coordinator or tour manager regarding the next day. So this is a very good time to make sure that everything on that sheet is finalized and get it in the inbox of your crew so that they can see it after loadout. Something else you will have to find time to do before the end of the night is settle out your finances with your runner, settle out with the venue and your catering and your hospitality budgets. So if you went over budget, it's something that needs to be addressed. If you're under budget, usually you can get a buyout for the rest of the money, but just settling up all of your finances and receipts with your runner, making sure your float is in order, and making sure you're settled up with the venue. In most cases, the tour manager will do the final settlement, the show settlement, with the promoter of the show. Sometimes the production coordinator is involved, and sometimes they're not. That is really dependent on the tour itself. After the show can always be a bit chaotic, depending on how many guests you have. If you have bands who like to hang out and party, or if you have bands who like to get out of there immediately, it's all a very different situation. But you are responsible for making sure that your band members either get onto the bus safely without being bombarded by fans, or they get back to the hotel safely. This requires a lot of running around and coordinating with your transportation people, as well as security from the venue or your own security, to just make sure that your band is protected, because there's always lots of fans hanging around the venue trying to meet the band after the show, and you just have to avoid those situations as much as possible. Some bands like to meet their fans. That is another thing that the production coordinator will have to deal with, because like I said, you want to make sure that security is involved and everything is as safe and orderly as possible. If we're on a bus tour, you are also responsible for getting the bus driver drivers from their hotel back to the buses for your overnight drive. The bus drivers are usually pretty independent. You just have to make sure that they have their bus driver meals, the instructions for the next day, where they're going, and that they're back at their bus about an hour before bus call. Once you're done with all that, you can focus on the loadout of the show. The loadout is removing everything that you loaded in that morning. So you want to break down the entire stage, the production office, the dressing rooms, everything you brought in. You just want to make sure it all gets out of the venue. The loadout takes anywhere from 2 to 4 hours, depending on the size of the production. Each department is responsible for their own gear and their own cases, but the production manager and the stage manager are in charge of the general loadout and making sure everything gets on the truck. And as the production coordinator, one of your responsibilities is assisting the production manager. So some production coordinators are more involved in the loadout, some are less, but just being there for your production manager and making sure that if they need anything, you're available to help them. Once the gear is packed, your crew will hopefully want to shower. So shower management at the end of the night is also the role of the production coordinator. Patrick is smiling at me right now, but it is true. You have to make sure that everybody gets into the shower and on the buses by bus call time. Call time is the time you set with the production manager on when you need to roll. If the bus call time is 3 o'clock, that means buses are moving at 3. And if you're not on the bus, you are left behind. Although that's not necessarily true because we do have bus moms. And as the production coordinator, it's my responsibility to make sure that everyone is on the buses and we're not leaving anybody behind as we move cities. So at the end of the night, you're doing a general wrap up, clean up, and overview of the entire venue, making sure no item and no person is left behind as you move cities. Hopefully you get to go right to a hotel, and then it would be your responsibility as the production coordinator to get everybody checked into the hotel for that day. If you're rolling right into another show day, then your wonderful day starts all over again from load-in. As I said before, each tour is a little bit different, and every production coordinator will have slightly varying responsibilities, but you are the glue that holds the entire day together, and you are responsible for keeping everybody fed, healthy, happy, and on time throughout the entire production. I hope you guys enjoyed my overview of a show day as a production coordinator in the music industry. Please drop me a comment if you have any other questions about this crazy life and this crazy job that I do, and we can get Patrick to make me do another video. So leave any questions you have below, and hopefully I'll see you guys back on Patrick and Friends soon.